गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ आई हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट इंटरनेट बेसिक्स. सो इन दैट केस यू कैन गिव द एग्जांपल्स अबाउट इंटरनेट. एज यू नो इंटरनेट इज अ नेटवर्क ऑफ नेटवर्क्स. सो इन द सेम सीरीज आई वांट टू डिस्कस हियर सम पॉइंट्स अबाउट इंटरनेट. So, in that one topic, that is website. Website, as you know, it is a collection of many web pages. So, first of all, the question arises in front of us. What is a web page? Actually, web page is an individual page, digital web page. Digital page that can be shown with the help of HTML, with the help of internet. If we are making anything, so that can be shown with the help of internet. So if for the purpose of internet we are making the web page, we are making the page, so that page can be called as a internet. Here the question arises that why we are making the web page. The web page, as you know, if we are not making web page, for that it can be that there will be a problem, or you can say it can be shown in the form of PDF. So if we want that about these details, if we want to discuss here, for that just I am giving you the example. So first of all, here we are making one web page by writing some codes. So as you know that with the help of HTML tag we are able to write any web page, or you can say the code of HTML we are able to write here with the help of HTML tag. After that, here we are writing head, so head should be closed. In the previous video I have told you why we are writing this. As you know that this should be taken HTML page that is divided into two categories, in two parts. First is head portion and second is body portion. So that's why we have written here head. In that we can write title. So in between title you can give any example, anything like XYZ, then title. HTML is not a case sensitive language, so don't worry that this will be written in small or this will be written in capital. So doesn't matter, but you have to keep in your mind that if any container tag you are using, that should be closed also. So the question arises that what is the use of container, what is the use of empty. Actually I have to tell, if we are taking the example of any empty tag, in that we can say this will be the starting tag. Only starting tag if it is, not the ending tag. Not the ending tag, then it will be called empty tag. For example, we are taking the example of br tag. So br that is used for break the line. So here if this type of tag you are using, that can be called empty tag. And if starting as well as closing tag you are using, that will be counted in the category of container tag. After that, the body portion we are starting. So in that, maybe we are writing the thing about any need. So, in this example, I have made one web page. If we are saving it with the name of any file name, after that by using .htm extension with the .htm extension, so it will be known as a that it will be in the form of HTML web page. So today's I want to tell you about website, that if we are taking this type of web pages, number of web pages we are taking, so collection of web pages is called website. I think you are thinking how it will be connected. If we are connecting, so here another term that is called anchor. So anchor term is that term in that you can say that it will be counted to connect one web page to another web page. So collection of different web pages is called web site. So here the question is that if we are talking about the component of a website, that the different thing that will come, like here, components of website. First is web host. Second is home page. Third one is web address. Like address, like country, like content, and one more thing, that is design also. So so in today's videos I'm going to tell you the content, or you can say the component of the website. As you know that this content that is understood, or the components of the website that will be discussed later. But now I want to tell you the some points regarding this. First of all, that is web host. Actually, web host, you can divide two words like web and host. So web means internet and host means those who are providing the things. So on that computer this website that has to be uploaded, and after that the person, those who are sitting at the different places, if they want to search it, so the content of this web page that can be given to that computers. So from that computer, from where this address that has the website or the contents of the websites that has to be displayed. So the question is that web host is that computer that is having the website or the service of the website that is provided by the computers or the by that programs. So you can say it is a physically address, physically computers on that this website is uploaded. So from where the service of that website that can be given to the different persons, so that can be called web host. One more thing, that is home page. Actually home page, you can say the first page of the website. If we are connecting the different pages, so the different page, in that first page of any website, that can be called as a home page. Whether the description of the website or any other things, if you are talking about that, so that can be called as a, that can be called here as a home page. One more thing, that is address. If we are storing the website at one place, so definitely it is having its own address. Suppose that you are storing one website like SDBP, like abc.html, yeah, HTML. So here this address can be accessed by anyone. So this is the link through that you are able to know how our website that is workable. So here the point is that if we are talking about this, it means we are talking about the address, we are telling the address of the website to anyone, so that is called address of the website. One more thing, question is arises in front of us that what do you mean by content? Actually content is nothing special. It means what you want to do here, like suppose that you are making this website for the purpose of school, our school. So you have to keep each and everything regarding our school. Maybe in the home page you are displaying the logo and the other pictures or the introductions about our school. After that, you can take some another example also. Different informations you are having about your school. So which content you are having, so it can be called here as a content of the website. Which what content you are taking? One more thing, that is design. Means if you are taking the design of the website, in that you are having the colorful websites, so in that you are having pictures, you are having the tables, you are having the pattern. So which type of pattern you are having, so that can be called here as a design. One more thing I have to discuss here, that if we are talking about the other content of the website, so I have to tell here that if we are making any colorful web pages, colorful websites, for that the different attribute, it is also provided here. So later on I have to discuss all these things. So till that you have to wait, and after that I will tell you.